Welcome to our very special guests, Marilyn and Stuart. Marilyn is our community executive, and together with her assistant Em, is responsible for three buildings.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Marilyn. Happy birthday to you.
It's us and a group of great professionals. We hope that we've included something for everyone. May I introduce our compere for this afternoon, Mr. Harvey Manning.
What a day this has been, what a rare mood. Almost like there's a smile on my face for that whole. Why, it's almost like being in love. Now the music of life seems to be like a bell that goes ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I'd swear I was falling. I know that I'm falling. It's almost like being in love.
Underneath the arches. Now, I want you to give a very big welcome to, and when they finish, Flo and Faye.
I dream my dreams away. Underneath the arches, on cobblestones I lay. Every night to find me tired and worn. Happy when the daylight comes creeping in the dawn, sleeping when it's raining, and sleeping when it's fine, I'd hear the train rattling high above. Pavement is my pillow, don't matter how I stay, underneath the arches.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Flo and Faye. We're going to see them a bit later on, is that
Okay. I go cleaning windows, turning on this bulb. Window cleaner is an interesting job. If I got the dust so clean, a window cleaner you would be. But you can see what I can see when I'm cleaning windows. In my profession, I work hard. When I'm cleaning windows, I'm leaning on a lamp. Maybe you think that I'm a tramp. Oh, you might think I'm a man to steal a car. But no, I'm the lady from mine. I don't know if she'll get away. She doesn't always get away. But if they happen, I'll just try. I hope the little lady won't mind. There's no other girl I would wait for. This one I'd break any day for. Oh, that's the way what she's late for. Oh, she wouldn't leave me flat. She's not a girl like that. And now I see. La 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 la.
Why am I always right, mate? Never very late.
explain. Ever a blushing bride. Ding dong, ring wedding bells. Always good for other girls. One fine day. Please let it be true. Wake up in the morning of my own.
All I want is a room somewhere, far away from the cold night air, with one in armor's chair. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Lots of chocolate for me to
see your lips.
kisses, the sunburned hand.
Old friends. One says to the other, "Hello, Sarah, how are you?" And Sarah replies, "I'm very well, thank you. There is nothing the matter with me. I'm as healthy as I can be. I have arthritis in both my knees. And when I talk in a wheeze. My pulse is weak and my blood is thin. But I'm awfully well for the shape I am. Arch supports I have for my feet, or I wouldn't be able to be out on the street. Sleep is denied me night after night, but every morning I find I'm all right. My memory is fading, my head's in a spin, but I'm awfully well for the shape I'm in. The moral is this, as my tale I unfold, that for you and me, who are getting old, it's better to say I'm fine with a grin than to let folks know the shape we are in. How do I know that my youth is all spent? Well, my get up and go has got up and went. But I really don't mind when I think with a grin of all the grand places my got up has been. Old age is golden, I've heard it said, but sometimes I wonder as I get into bed, with my ears in a drawer, my teeth in a cup, my specs on the table until I get up. Ere sleep overtakes me, I say to myself, is there nothing else I could lay on the shelf? When I was young, my slippers were red, I could kick my heels right over my head. When I was older, my slippers were blue, I could still dance the whole night through. Now I'm old, my slippers are black. I walk to the shop and puff my way back. I get up each morning and dust my wits. I pick up the paper to read the obits. My name is still missing. I know I'm not dead. And so I have breakfast and go back to bed.
Love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it.
Singing, maybe it's because I'm a Londoner. Thank you, Charlie. I know I do. I know.
Maybe it's because I'm a Londoner. By the dozen,
below. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one more going nowhere just for sure. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see or hear, squawking just as noisily as they can, with each loud gee-gobbly-gah, would land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say there lived a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, all day long I'd really, really bum. If I were a wealthy man, wouldn't have to work hard, yabba-dibba-zabba-dibba-dabba-dibba-dabba-dum. All day long I'd be really rich, idle-dibble-idle-idle-man. I'd see my wife, my golden, looking like a rich man's wife, with a proper double chin, supervising meals to a heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oy, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important man in town will come to fall on me. They will ask me to advise them like Solomon the wise.
If you please, Rebtebia, I hope Papa will meet Rebtebia.
Posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. And boy. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray. Maybe have a seat by the eastern, and I discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. This would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, all day long I'd really, really want. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Lord, you made the lion and the lamb. You decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some past eternal plan if I were a wealthy man?
Shalom, shalom, shalom. Business, I know.